For over 100 years, scientists have studied where intelligence comes from. Are some people just born smarter than everybody else? Or can each of us build up our intelligence over time? What skills can we learn? And what skills are just genetic? What makes someone smart anyway? Over time, we've discovered that our brains are much more flexible than we ever imagined. They're kind of like muscles. The more we exercise them, the stronger and faster they get. No one is born knowing how to read or build a supercomputer. But with practice, anyone can learn these things. Here's how it works. Our brains are made up of billions and billions of tiny cells called neurons. Each neuron has branches that reach out. When you learn something new or practice a skill, the neurons in specific parts of your brain grow. When the branches of two neurons get close enough, they form a neural pathway. Energy zings along these pathways, sending signals to different parts of the brain. Soon, a protective coating begins to form around the neural pathways. This coating, called myelin, helps the energy move even more quickly. Everything you do, feel, or think strengthens your neural pathways and makes it easier for you to do, feel, and think those things again. Let's say you want to organize a campaign at your school that inspires people to take action on a topic you care about. It may be difficult at first, but the more you experiment with strategies to help you stay organized and bring people together, the more those parts of your brain will grow and strengthen. Soon, you might notice that running your campaign isn't as hard as it used to be. You really can train your brain. That's great news, no matter what goal you're working on. But this process doesn't always work the way we want it to. If you learn and practice doing something the wrong way, it becomes easier to do it the wrong way again. That can make bad habits pretty hard to break. Luckily, you can also retrain your brain. With effort and attention, you can decide which neural pathways you'd like to strengthen and which pathways you'd like to fade away. As you tackle bad habits and work through your emotions, even as you make mistakes and keep trying, your brain lets old, unused connections go and forms new connections to help you reach your goals. And while myelination happens throughout your whole life, it really picks up in middle school. The frontal lobe of your brain, the part that helps you plan ahead, make decisions, and think logically, is myelinating at a faster rate now than it ever has before. Which means that, scientifically, now is a great time to decide how you want to build your brain. And the good news is that even after middle school, there's no expiration date on your potential. You can, and do, build connections and learn new things throughout your whole life. Your brain power isn't decided by your genes, your family, or what other people think or say about you. It's up to you. Whether you want to achieve a big, long-term goal, or just form some good daily habits, you can start building your brain to do those things anytime you want. So, what will you train your brain to do?